Since the violence started in South Sudan almost 6 months ago, in December 2013, the humanitarian situation in many parts of the country has deteriorated dramatically. Today, fighting continues in some parts of the country, and the living conditions of displaced people are quite alarming. In Lier, a town located in Unity State, hundreds of people are living in the bush or under a tree. Many of them, they are eating leaves from the trees or water lily, which is an aquatic flower, in order to survive. Many have lost their cattle. Others cannot resume their farming or fishing activities. Most lack proper shelter. There is growing food insecurity because the production of food has been disrupted in many places due to the ongoing violence. ICRC is conducting airdrop operations in order to provide food for those in need in specific locations throughout South Sudan. This is the case of Lier Town in Unity State. And this is very good news for hundreds of people living there. We accompanied a woman called Niaput to her house when she received the food assistance. She registered with the Red Cross volunteers. And several days before the airdrop took place, and the day of the distribution, she woke up very early. So she went to the distribution point very early in the morning and waited until she received the food. Then she put the bag on top of her head, and we followed her to her house. And I remember that I thought that she's a really strong woman, even if she's quite small and thin. And she looked so weak. She was so happy that she had finally food for her kids. When we arrived at the house, there were three huts made of mud, but two of them were burnt when the violence was hitting Lier. So there's only one remained in that space when the fighting ceased. She is trying to build right now a fence around the remaining house, so she hopes the family can return home soon. Although the situation is calm now, she was still afraid of bringing her kids back to the house due to the prevailing insecurity. The fact that the ICRC is using planes to airdrop food makes such a difference in the lives of these people. It's a matter of life and death for them. The one thing that impressed me so much when I was there is that while these people were waiting for weeks to get food, they were so respectful and humble while waiting to receive the assistance. No one was fighting or shouting. They knew that ICRC truly wanted to help them. They understand and they respect the colleagues who are working so hard to provide everyone with food. But the longer the conflict and the lack of security, if it persists, the more difficult it will be for people to obtain food and other basic needs. I think it's more difficult for them to get a normal life.